most trusted advisor, it seems nothing can stop the detestable Xiongnu. Despite strenuous efforts to halt their forays into the Ordos, they managed to break through, and now our once proud city of Hao has been ignominiously sacked. It seems the soldiers did not rally when the beacon fires were lit, as too many times before, King Yeo had them fired just to see a smile on the face of a petulant concubine. Yeo Wang now lies dead in the ashes of Hao, and our new regent, Ping Wang, fears for his life. For this reason, the capital is being moved eastward. It is your good fortune, noble commissioner, that engineers have already constructed strong defenses at Loyi. However, the site for a temple complex must still be staked out. More income from trade can be had by striking coins at the mint, and soldiers armed with powerful crossbows can now protect the city. Nutritious soybeans will supplement your citizens' diet. The river provides tasty fish, but also a certain danger, as heavy spring rains can cause flash floods.
Hey guys, welcome back to Emperor Rise of the Middle Kingdom, and we are here in spring and autumn weather in turbulent winds. And it seems like, all of our efforts at the front of Ordos didn't really work. so we lost the city of Hao, and we need to reach population 3,250 people in humble compounds or better, and a temple complex must be built. But it seems like we're going to be starting with some stuff. Oh, there we go. We start with some city walls. So the more we build inside, the better, because it'll be easier to defend. So let's see what we're dealing with here. It's a pretty large map, lots of open space. All of this is quite useful. All this open space right here is really nice. We've got water and we've got fish. And what are these? Are these? They're just rocks. Okay. Alright, so we got some trees in here. We got some stones inside. So for good feng shui, there's a couple stones there as well, for those things that require it. What is this? Stone quarry. Quarries are rich in stone, build a stoneworks to carve stone from the earth. Okay. So let's have a look at our food. We have farmhouse hemp farm, soybean wheat field, and hemp field with fishing keys. So we got three kinds of food. We've got silkworm sheds and hemp, okay. We've got clay pits, logging sheds, stoneworks. So these stoneworks are supposed to go like that? I'm not sure what stone is used for. Weaver, jade carver studio, a bronze smelter. Okay, that's very nice. Commerce, mill, market square, shops, trading stations. We're already trading with Khufu and Anyang. Okay. So, that seems pretty good. Now, what was it talking about the mint? I wasn't too sure. I've heard a bit about the mint, and I've read a bit about it, and apparently it increases the amount of money you make from exports, but let's have a look at table of contents. Let's have a look. M. There we go. M. Mint. The mint must be built next to a road and on clear terrain. You may only have one mint in your city and it requires labor. Miners from the mint go to copper ore sites to gather copper, which the mint then turns into strings of cash for your treasury. Furthermore, when you have a mint, your cash revenues from trade are automatically increased. The use of coins facilitates trade. Okay. But I don't see any mint building. Do I need to build an administrative city first and maybe a palace? Maybe I gotta get those down before I can actually build a mint, because I don't see any new building here. That's a watchtower. Tax office. There's a weaponsmith, huh? Well, either way, we're probably gonna be attacked considering there's a temple complex. We're probably gonna be attacked considering the walls pretty soon, especially. So I do want to set up military right from the start of the game. So I'm gonna put down a couple housing blocks here. And farms, I'm not sure if we could fit the farms inside the city walls, or maybe we should leave them outside here. Maybe out here will be fine, because there's some nice space right there. And I'm gonna start some bronze working and some bronze smelting and weaponsmith straight away, because I really want to make sure I don't get surprise attacked by anyone. And the nomad camps, I should probably send a spy to them as well to get an earlier warning of attacks. Alright, so we've got a bit of a plan. We'll see how it works out. All right, so there we go. We've set up two residential blocks here, and they're starting to move in, which is fantastic. And you can see I'm sort of planning for the marketplace to go there and there. So it's pretty space efficient using this and using those rocks for the good feng shui here to get that all green. Yes, it's fantastic. And over here, I've just gone ahead and put down one bronze smelter and one weaponsmith just so we can get military going pretty quick. And that means we also need to get some government going, which is the administrative city, which I do need to place somewhere along here. I'm not sure where's the best place for this. Farms are probably going to go outside, so I can probably place it somewhere around here, but I should put down the marketplace first. Once we put down the first administrative city, we can go ahead and put down an infantry fort. And also, oh, there we go, 100 people. A new thing here, crossbowmen fort. So we'll be able to get, well, we can train crossbows, which might be somewhat better than chariots. All right, so I do want to get military going as soon as possible, but let's go to the world map, go to the nomad camps. I'm going to send a spy to the gather information, and that costs quite a bit, but I want to know when we're going to be attacked by the nomad camps, because as far as I know, Yulin was the edge of the Ordos, and you can, Hao has fallen apparently. So I expect the nomad camps to come and attack us down here in Loyi. Meanwhile, for trade, we could start selling some wood and some bronzeware. That should be our focus, but I'm not sure if we're gonna get enough people from this first move-in. I mean, we could try and to set up a dock for the water trade route. It's a little awkward because you can see we'll have to like demolish some of this wall to get it done properly. I'm not sure if we'll be able to do that. Maybe if I could kind of squeeze it there, but I'm not sure if it's good feng shui. Well, we could try to figure that out. Anyway, people are moving in. Do we have unemployment yet? 16 workers needed. So letting this sort of get going. Of course, safety is the main priority here. And I do need to get some kind of food in to start feeding my people because we're just gonna run out of people to work with, really. Hey, would you look at that? This city is really coming together really nicely. I like how these roads are connecting the way I planned it. And the administrative city is gonna go right there. And I think over here is where our luxury high-level housing can go. You know, the elite housing. That can go around this sort of block there. But down here, I went ahead and put down a trading post to Anyang and two logging sheds because we can sell 12 wood a year. So we're gonna go ahead and do that. But to get good feng shui for the inspector's tower, it had to go across the river, so I had to build this bridge over. This might not be the best ever, but this stretch here can definitely be used for the fishing keys, like right there. It fits perfectly, very nice. But since putting this down, we do have under government tab here, the mint. And what's this? The nomad camps are extremely angry with me. No telling what they might do. Okay, let's slow it down a bit. Is our spy over there spying on them? Hopefully it gives us a heads up rather than 6 months. Anyway, we do have some bronze coming in and this mint, as far as I understand, it should be placed near all of this bronze and it should turn into money basically. So let's go ahead and place this down somewhere. How do I want to place it? I think I'll just place it right there. So what does this do? Converting copper into cash. All is quiet at the mint, no employees, okay. Miners collect copper ore so it can be converted into strings of cash at the mint. Okay, so that's basically free money, right? All right, and since we do have that, we should put down an infantry fort when we can. I think, is this a good place to have infantry? Or it should be somewhat closer to the city, I think. Let me pause the game here while I find a good spot. Around these rocks here should be a good spot for our infantry because that will allow us to respond by either protecting our industry up north or heading east to defend the walls there or heading south to defend the walls there. So, let's see, how do we do this? Well, I think I'll just bring the road down this way and, yeah, set up the forts around here in a way that makes sense. Yeah, like right there. That looks good. So we would actually have the fort there, and the road will extend through here. And one, two, three. Let's do that. Okay, perfect. Alright, so I did a bit of reorganizing actually, and I shifted the administrative city slightly to the right because I wanted the mill to be here, because the other market square is gonna go there, so it's not too far from the mill. And I put down these two farms here outside the city because I was thinking I could actually squeeze it in, but I don't want it to get too crowded inside, and farmhouses aren't all that important anyway. And there seemed to be a nice spot for them here. And we've just reached 500 people, fantastic, because we do need some more workers. And we are actually selling the wood. We sold 4 so far, and the mint over on this side is actually working. It's 93% complete. How is this gonna work? We got 6,300 now. How much does it give? 96? Okay, 6,234. 6,234. And then how much do we get? 100. Okay. So we get 100 every time. It turns 100 copper into 100 strings of cash. That's not a lot, but it's enough to get things going. Meanwhile, we're getting our first set of troops here, but we could definitely do with more. So let's go ahead and put another bronze smelter right there, and we'll put down another weaponsmith as well. There we go, weaponsmith right here, I think. So we got two weaponsmiths going, and a bit of extra bronze is actually coming in. So we should start getting our troops built up pretty soon. So people are starting to move in, but I don't think I can build any more industry until I get more people to move in. So I gotta wait for this next harvest for all of our crops. When is it? It's gonna be starting in March, begins in May. Okay, so this year we're gonna get the food in. We will focus our agriculture to make sure we get enough food in. And once there's a nice big stockpile of food, I'll start feeding this area down here. And that should get us enough people to get things going even further. Oh, would you look at that! The Xiongnu army from the nomad camps will attack in just 6 months. Really? 6 months? I don't know if I'm gonna be able to handle this. I mean, wait, no. This is, I'm gonna put this down first. Okay, I'm starting a bronzeware industry here, but, I started this military as soon as the map started. I could not have done it any faster. I mean, I hope one infantry fort is enough to handle it. I might need to invest in a few more towers, though. Like, I might want to put a bunch of towers along these walls, depending on which side they attack from. I mean, this side seems a little defenseless. We might want to squeeze in another tower or two here, like another two towers. Because this side, there's these two. And yeah, it's a bit bare on this side as well. So I don't know which side they're gonna attack from, but I hope we'll have enough infantry to deal with it. I mean, we've got two bronzeware makers there. Our employees are actually doing okay. We're gonna hit enough people even with this expanded bronzeware industry. Hopefully this actually gets us enough weapons to build up a large enough army. 6 months isn't a long time. Alright, so here we go. In 1 month, they're gonna invade. I don't think I could have boosted this anymore. I mean, I only just stabilized on employment, and we've only got 5-6 infantrymen. I hope these walls do hold up. Let's just slow the game down. I'm gonna go ahead and boost my fortifications. Let's go and get some towers, and we're gonna place some towers along these walls. I think that's the middle, or is this the middle? This looks right. How's this? Yeah, it should look slightly on this side because of the perspective. So let's place a tower there. And we'll place a tower here. Okay. And they should attack from the north, so they should either come from this side. But usually they don't come from where people are walking in. The immigrants come from here, so I'm assuming it's not going to come from here. You can see our food's coming in as well, so that's going to be good. So we've got this wall pretty much as prepared as it can be. Let's go and start manning the towers. That should take up our employment. 96 workers needed. Jeez, let's boost this back up. Really, 96? 75. Okay. That's you can't disable specific let's stop manning the towers then. That's gonna take a lot of people out of our workforce. So let's make sure things are going as smoothly as possible. And we're getting a few more weapons in. So we should get a couple more infantrymen, but this doesn't seem like a lot. Really, at all. I don't know if we're gonna be okay. Let's just see how fast we can go. I mean, I doubled my weapon production here. And here they go. Go to site of event. Here! Damn it. They're gonna take out our industry. Well, we might have to pull back, actually. Let's see what we're up against first. It's not a lot, but I know if we lose our troops, we can be considered conquered. Man the towers, please. Let's pull our troops back. All right, where are they going? That's quite a lot of them, actually. Are they just going straight for our walls here? Well, let's engage these people. Come on. I don't know if they're gonna be able to break through our walls, but we're doing our best here. At least they bypassed my industry. Oh, they're attacking my farms. Okay, I'm not too concerned about that. All right. You guys, come on, attack, come here. It seems like their horsemen are a little spread out. Can we start attacking these guys? No? Okay. Well, they're still... No, no, come here, come on. Let's kill as many as we can. We've got the backup of all these crossbowmen. There's so many of them. If we lose all our troops, does it count us as conquered? I don't know. Well, there's not much we can do now. Ah, damn it, we got conquered. Okay, I think I gotta redo that, but I gotta make sure I don't lose my troops. I gotta let them die to the towers. Oh, we can't let ourselves be conquered. All right, I've changed a few things around. So first of all, let me slow the game down just to show you what's going on. I picked up a few stragglers, so the infantry are already retreating. Look at them go. Chi Hu Wei, Heng Kou, Treacherous Snakes, Han Fei Zi, they're all retreating. And over here, I boosted my weapons production as much as possible, so we did get a few extra troops out of it. So now, we just have to make sure that we let these guys die to our crossbowmen on the walls and try to pick off a few stragglers. I don't think we can actually kill this guy right here. Look at that. Can I... I don't think I can get him. He's kind of on the water, so we can't actually get him. I'm afraid of charging into there, because we might lose our troops. So, we might lose a couple farmhouses, we might lose our soybean harvest, but never mind. Let's start feeding the people with plain food first. We'll put down two food shops. Okay, so that guy's dead. Now it's just these horses, and they're slowly dying. I don't know if I can, maybe if I run down here and pick up the stragglers. We'll be okay. Let's speed up the game a bit. So we lose the soybean harvest. That's fine. Let's kill this horse right here. Okay. Kill that guy. And then we'll try kill the ones around the gate here. Because they're not all clumped up like they were last time. Alright, let's speed this up. If we kill enough of them, they'll start retreating. Okay, we're losing some soldiers, but we killed two of their horses. Come on, kill a few more. And you can see we're getting reinforcements because we're producing more weapons than we were last time. Alright. We killed 3 horses so far. Let's kill one more. Okay. We actually won, I think. But I don't know how we're gonna... Can we actually get the rest of these guys? I don't think so. I don't think we can actually get them. We're gonna have to wait until these crossbowmen actually take them out. All right.
Fall has arrived. Finally, a chance for me to test my mettle.
All right, so go back to the fort. So, on the back of this, let's get another I haven't built my palace yet. This is before I built my palace. Are we feeding these houses? Oh, they don't have an ancestral shrine. Let's go ahead and place one of those down. Too close to enemy troops, damn it. We gotta wait for this to end before we can evolve our houses. Alright, so let's just speed it up. And they're slowly dying. Alright, invasion dealt with. And they're retreating, and of course they killed that wheat guy. Great news! Fantastic. Let's place these two down, slow the game down a bit. Stop manning the towers, because we need the people. And that should evolve these houses, allowing us to start getting into some bronzeware making, which we can sell and start making money. Alright, fantastic! So, now that that invasion is over, I went and put down the hemp farms here. It's the next year, we're now farming more soybeans and wheat, and that food's gonna come in soon enough. Now, why are we sending wood this way? What needs wood? Is it... I don't know. I did put down the storage yard. Is it accidentally sending the wood that side? Possibly, because I think we sold... We're selling quite a bit of wood over here, but it's not full in by any means of the word. But, these houses have evolved, so more people have moved in, which allowed me to set up these hemp farms, which I'm going to be using the hemp to give to the gods. And I've also shifted a bit away from weapon production into all this bronzeware making, and bronzeware is coming in, and we could sell 24 a year. And we got to get that industry going, because, it's gonna take quite a bit of bronzeware to actually make enough money, but we are setting up a second infantry fort anyway, and we can see that wood is going back. Alright, so once this harvest comes in, we'll get plain food, and once the hemp comes in, we'll be able to provide hemp as well, evolving these houses to the next level, so that's gonna be good. But for now, we do need to... maybe we could start a ceramics industry? No, we do need the people. I mean, 61 workers needed, but these guys are coming in to buy the bronze. How much is this worth? Is it possible? Like, I know it said having a mint actually, having a mint improves the amount of money we make from sales. How much do we get from this? That's quite a good amount. That's like 200 plus per unit of bronzeware. That's gonna keep us afloat, definitely. Oh well, however that works, we seem to be doing okay. We gotta boost our military so we're not vulnerable to any more attacks, but I think to get more military... Yeah, we need to get elite housing to boost our military further, but this farmland is looking fantastic. I'm not sure if I should have left that row of trees there. The map sort of started with it and it looked kinda nice. Looks kinda weird now though. Oh well, never mind. So yeah, this is gonna go swimmingly, I think. Alright, so there we go. We've evolved these houses up to spacious dwellings and people are starting to flood in. And plenty of hemp coming in means we can keep the gods happy. This Huang Di is kind of unhappy right now. Let's give him a medium offering. I gave 2 great offerings this year already, so the amount of hemp coming in is enough to supply our residential areas and keep the gods happy. To evolve these houses further, they need appetizing food, but... I don't know what we should be focusing on right now. We should probably focus on exports, because we don't currently know what all these other people are trading. So let's try open trade with the city. It only costs 100 to ask. So let's go ahead and open trade. We probably should have done this earlier, but let's go ahead and just request to open trade with everyone so we can see what they want. And the nomad camps, well, Anna, we sent a spy to them earlier, but it didn't seem to increase the amount of time we needed, the time we got to deal with their invasion. It still said 6 months. Anyway, I went ahead and destroyed this wall just a little bit, because I realized if I move this wall slightly over, then we can actually, I'll rebuild it, of course, we can access the trees, which are over on this side, so I could increase my logging shed by one, and I can start taxing the people over here, which is fantastic. So they can now walk over this side to get these trees, which I'll leave there, and it puts less strain on chopping this way, increasing the amount of wood we're selling, and also allowing us to tax our people, which, since we're doing that, we might as well put down a second tax office. Where's a good place for this? Right there. Is that good? That's good. And, oh, the nomad camps want 7 bolts of silk in 4 months. We're not making silk at all. Plus, they invaded us last time. I don't think we're gonna comply to that, because keeping them happy might just keep them away from our city for a little while, but, oh well, I hopefully they won't be able to conquer us, because we can't build any more military until we actually get, some elite housing. So I'm now prepping for an elite housing area, because I do want to expand my military. So what I did is I set up this sort of area over here, and we're still staying above board here. We're not going into any debt, and well, this is all looking fantastic. I'm going to be using these gray walls for the elite housing, and I might have to move these two over. Now, I do have 2 types of food here, but to evolve these houses to the next step, they need appetizing food. So I set down all of these fishing wharves here.
Quite a load of fish today. The cormorants were busy.
All right, kind of a weird accent though, but I put down 5 fishing keys, and that's going to be bringing in as much fish as possible, and hopefully that actually comes over here, supplies enough fish for a third type of food, and then we can evolve all of these houses, giving us enough people to start supplying, well, a ceramics industry, which I suppose I could start setting up right now. I mean, is there good feng shui for ceramics down here? I think there definitely is. We could fit a couple things here. With a bit of planning? Sure, why not? Let's go ahead and place down... Well, we'll place it... how about the kilns? There's a bit of good feng shui over here. If I place it like that, that gives a bit. And... oh yes, the nomad camp still wants the silk. So we could create a bit of a ceramics industry here. Just a small one. We'll have to place more maybe out there? This is just going to supply a little bit for now, because even to place elite housing, it needs 1 crate of ceramics just to get the ceramics in. Anyway, fish is starting to come in, so that means we're going to start supplying 3 types of food to our housing here. And yeah, all the bean curds are coming in as well. So we got 3 types of food going, which is basically the minimum requirement for elite housing. And I'm not sure if... is this road too long? I'm not too sure. But that definitely needs to be blocked off. Okay. I'm not sure if this block is too long, but we'll find out soon enough. And yeah, there we go. 3 types of food. Does that, they need ceramics to evolve further? Okay, I should actually make a space for that. So let's drop this. And I forgot to give a bunch of hemp to the gods. There we go. And... no one wanted to open trade with me, but woo, actually a few places would like to buy weapons and silk. So weapons and silk is actually something that we could definitely trade with. So Yulin buys weapons and silk, and so does woo. We could basically expand into weapons and silk for all sorts of things, but Yulin also buys wood. So let's go ahead and send a gift. Let's send a gift to Yulin of weapons, I think. Small gift of 4 racks of weapons, or do we have any wood to give? They also like wheat. But, let's give the weapons, because we don't have any use for the weapons right now. Alright, we'll send a gift to Yulin, then we'll hopefully open trade, and we can start selling weapons, any surplus weapons anyway, and then also wood, and all sorts of things. So that should settle, we should settle or set up a silk industry rather. I think it should go over on this side, because elite housing is on this side. And I'm not sure if this storage yard is too far away from that. Huh. I might need to place a second storage yard over here. Let's go ahead and place it down right now. Right there. And we can set this to accepting a bit of hemp. Just 8, I guess. We'll make it 12, since we're very much overproducing that. And then whenever we overproduce hemp, so the surplus will run off into there. Okay, so things looking good. Fish is trickling in, keeping our three types of food going. And they need ceramics to evolve further. So we gotta set up a ceramics industry. All right, so we've managed to open up trade with Yulin, and they buy silk weapons and wood. So I went ahead and put this down here, the trading station with Yulin, expanded our industry down this way, and put down two logging sheds to supply the 12 wood we can sell a year. And the weapons, we can sell 12 a year as well. So we're just gonna sell the excess. So this warehouse can now empty out those weapons, get rid of that, and we'll make a bit of a bank from all of this, because weapons, as far as I know, sell for quite a bit, and that should stabilize our economy, which actually, in this mission, economy's been something that's been not bad. Anyway, I put down one elite housing here, and we're starting to... I'm just gonna supply a little bit to this area, so that we actually have... I can see that I can maintain some elite housing. But once the ceramics come in to this side, then we'll be able to provide ceramics here and increase our workers, which I think we should go ahead and put down a ceramic shop right now. I would start feeding this area, but food supply seems to be just about hanging on here. With these two food shops here, we actually got a massive stock of appetizing food. And this side as well, yeah, with only one house to feed here, it should be okay. But I'm not sure if, ooh, look.
I'm on my way, but I'll surely be back for another trading day.
Traders from Yulin, because they're a desert map, actually have camels. I don't think I've seen that before. Look at that. That's fantastic. Anyway, I'm not sure if this road is too long for the market. Let me just, this market trader here. Oh, the grand marketplace is actually sent down two traders. Well, do they actually make it all the way around? Almost. I think they do. All right, so this road is not too big. Fantastic. And fish is actually coming in at a pretty decent rate now. Wheat's just about coming in, and soybean's gonna replenish just as we're running out. Fantastic. And besides all that, oh, we actually maxed out on weapons here. Let's just have plenty of extras. What's the max here? 60? So we could just store as many weapons as we like there. We'll also might be selling. So what's 60 minus 24? That's 60, don't do math on air. It should be 36? Okay, so we'll store that much weapons in there. So we could sell that in one go. And we can get rid of this, don't put it there. Okay, getting rid of that. And yeah, we should start up a silk industry. So, money is now looking pretty good. We're at 5,500, and this guy's just gonna start buying wooden weapons here. There we go. Alright, now, we're gonna be making quite a bit of money from here on out now that we've opened up that trade route, so we can start planning bigger things. This house here is not visited by tax. Why does it only have 10 food, though? Has this... this still has food, so it should be fine. They just don't eat that much, I guess. Alright, so, we can support this, and look at that, we got three types of food very nicely stocked up there, and these houses have evolved into elegant dwellings, though they need acrobat access, which, an acupuncturist access, so let's go ahead and put down an acupuncturist, and we should give this side one as well. Can we actually, it's not really a good spot for it. I might have to destroy a house to make room for that. How's that employment? Oh, that's fine. Let's see if it'll look good there. Acupuncturist. Fantastic. Alright, so these houses should evolve soon enough because they're gonna get acupuncturists and acrobats. And this needs a herbalist. Okay, we should start putting down all the usuals in this area. A new year has arrived. We should celebrate because, we got plenty of food. Oh, it took all the bean curds. I wish it wouldn't take a single type of food like that. How's our food supply is kind of okay. All right, but we do have to throw a festival every once in a while. And there we go. Ornate apartments, the highest level normal housing we can get because we don't have Taoist buildings. And all of these are evolving now. What's causing them to evolve? Is it the acupuncturist? I think so. All right, so all this is looking stable. We got plenty of money coming in and we should start taxing people. Now we gotta start evolving these modest Sahir ones into humble compounds, and we gotta get started on that temple complex as well. Oh, a building has just collapsed. Okay, what did I forget? Oh, this, right, of course. That guy probably can't reach far enough. Anyway, we set up a silk industry, and things should be going along quite nicely here. Since the inspector can't quite reach that far, let's go ahead and put down weavers a little closer. We could, I spread them out a bit anyway, so let's put them here and here. There we go, that looks okay. So we put down five silkworm sheds, right? And they're all harvesting silk now, I think. When is it? The next mulberry leaf harvest is in September? Okay. And that's gonna bring silk in, which will allow us to evolve this house, the Modest Sahir one, to higher levels. And also, because we're making... Oh, the nomad camps don't like me so much. Well, they did invade me. Anyway, I stopped selling bronzeware, and I know it's a very long trip to get down here, but I want to get bronzeware into here because this house, well, the higher level housing requires bronzeware to evolve further. So we got to get this in. But we're making enough money now anyway from Yu Lin selling weapons and wood, and soon we'll be selling silk there as well, another 12 silk, and a lot of other places will actually buy weapons and silk, I think. So let's see, who else? Wu? I think Wu buys weapons and silk? Let's send them a gift. No, let's send a gift of weapons. Small rack of 4 weapons to Wu. Then we'll start selling more weapons and silk, so we don't have to worry about selling bronze. And this is a long trip, but it's gonna have to do anyway. Look at all this farmland. Ceramics looking okay, hemp's looking okay. There we go, bronzeware's coming in, so let's go ahead and put down... Actually, let's save the bronze first, and wait until the silk comes in, I think. So there you have it, I managed to evolve this housing area, which is gonna send food supplies into a bit of instability, because it's just so much food. The first feeding always takes so much, but look at that. 14 occupants, extra room for 49, and I went ahead and put down one more of these farms inside the city walls, because, well, I wasn't really using that space, and, well, it's close to there, so next year we should get plenty of food, and hopefully this actually lasts until next year. We do still have 3 types of food going here, and, well, just gotta wait for the fish to come in, really. This area over here is doing okay, 750 stocked up, here is doing okay. This has evolved into a lavish Sahir one, but it needs tasty food, so we need to import salt. So what I did was here, I'm now importing salt, and I should drop the amount of stuff that's space that weapons taking up. Selling silk, of course, and we just opened up trade with Wu, which also buys silk and weapons. So let's go ahead and place that trading station down somewhere. Can it go right here? I think that's a fine place for it. So we're gonna be selling silk and weapons. They buy plenty of silk. I'm not sure if we want to sell that much silk. I think it'll be okay. We're producing lots of silk. So we'll be able to sell even more stuff there, so we really don't have to sell any more bronzeware for now. And we're now just producing bronzeware for the housing area, which is a bit extreme, but that's gonna be fine. Alright, we're still producing way too many weapons anyway. I'm not sure if this housing... Does it allow us... Oh! This type of housing does allow us to put down another fort. Where's a good spot for it? I think right there? Let's not block it. Let's place it right there. Another infantry fort's gonna be good to have. Crossbows take a bit of wood. We might want to get into that. But we didn't cave into the nomad camps for their request of silk, so they're now hostile to us. So we really do need the weapons to start training this stuff up. Anyway, salt's coming in. That's going to be our fourth type of food. And alright, it's the next farming season already. Just in time, as we're starting to run out of food right now. And a bit of desirability issues. But all this should be getting us quite a lot of unemployment. And the reason why I need all those people is because of the monument. We haven't even started the temple complex. And I'm thinking of placing it right here, right outside of our city. And it should be really nice if I place it somewhere here. I think if I get rid of this patch of trees, it'll look nice right around here. And it won't really block any pathway. And we're at 3,000 people. Very nice. We only need 3,200 for this mission. Alright, so I'm gonna have to start, wait for these people to move in, set up our monument, try to evolve this to the next level. Oh no, that flood! In the briefing it mentioned there was gonna be a flood! The river is swelling! Oh no! Well, it's a good thing the only thing near the water was our logging exports and a few fishing keys. we knew this was gonna happen at some point, but that's gonna be fine. Oh, so Wu wants 6 bronzeware vessels. Well, alright, we can dispatch that now. We got plenty of bronzeware vessels just lying around since we're not selling any, and we've completely run out of food, so I don't know if we're gonna be okay. I think the houses are actually going to be fine. It's actually okay. Anyway, we've set up our monument area, and I'm not exactly sure what it's going to require. Currently, it needs 5 stacks of wood and 20 carpenters. So, I guess we need more wood over on this side. So let's go ahead and put down another logging shed. Since we're slightly overproducing wood anyway, but I'm not sure. Has the river subsided yet? It has. Okay, let's slow the game down. We got to replace all of this. And, this also got destroyed. Let's not forget that. And, careful not to cut down any trees. And we'll put down all this stuff back. Does one fit there? It does. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh, we could actually fit one more than before. I didn't realize one could actually fit there. Alright, perfect. And we'll put back the trading key to Anyang. And put back the logging sheds for the wood trade and our taxing, and don't forget the inspector's tower. Okay, fantastic. All right, so this is all looking nice. I'm not sure. I've put down this laborers camp and everything. I don't know. Do they need wood? I guess they do, or something. But we'll see how this goes. Oh, I think wood is coming in here. Is this? No, woods, that's going somewhere else. Alright, we'll wait for this to get started. So the nomad camps are gonna invade one more time, and I'm not sure why, but I can't seem to get this temple complex to be built. It requires 5 stacks of wood and 20 carpenters, but I'm not sure. Here's the carpenters guild. We've got a warehouse with wood in it. I don't know how to initiate this monument building. I've got a laborer's camp, I've got one of each carpenter's guild, one of each guild. I don't know how to get this started. But either way, we've got 3/4 of infantry. I'm only just about getting more military things going. And can we actually put down more? We can actually put down more. I put down one crossbow fort there. We're gonna wait for that to get trained up. Weapons are heading there, and so is wood. Okay, so everything's working, except for this monument. I don't know why the monument's not building. I really don't know. But let's deal with this invasion first. It's gonna show up any second now. Let's just wait for it. Come on, where is it? Here we go. Where are they invading from? Down here, okay. That's a little unfortunate. But let's fight to defend the city. Let's slow this down. We're gonna have to bring everyone here. Are we manning the towers? We are manning. Okay. Let's bring all of our troops down here. Hopefully we can take them. I don't know how big this invasion is gonna be. They're gonna start killing our farmers though. You can hear them screaming already. Oh, that's quite a lot of them. but I think we can take them. That's like two groups of horses and one group of infantry. We can take them, but it's just unfortunate they're attacking from here. Because that's gonna... Yeah, this is gonna affect our food supply. Maybe I want to do a bit of a reload and move my troops over in this direction first. Alright, so I figured out what was going wrong with the temple complex, and apparently the wood can only be transported if you actually have a stack of four. If you don't have a stack of four, well, it won't actually be transported, so I put down one more logging shed. Anyway, I've brought my troops over this time, and they're gonna be here in, well, any second now, but this time my troops are in position to protect my... my farmers, because I really do need the food. I also upped the amount of farms. I put two more out here just to make sure our food supply is really, really stabilized. I don't want to risk, like, for example, if some of these farmers get killed, I don't want to risk all my houses devolving because that could cause me a complete loss. So, here we go. Infantry's in position. Now we just have to wait for the invasion. Alright. Any second. There we go. It is coming from here. Fight to defend the city. Now let's allow them to come a bit closer to us. So we get in range. All right, let's engage. You guys also come down here and engage. I'll save these guys for a little bit later. I suppose these guys can go around the back and engage these horses at the back. These horse archers. Damn Mongols. Alright. No, 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 don't go there! Follow orders! I'm not telling you to engage, I'm telling you to attack these guys! Fine. I can't control them. They're just wandering about, look at that. They're walking back and forth. Okay, finally, they're engaging these guys. Alright, let's see how much... Can we actually survive this? I hope so. We're losing quite a bit. Right, okay. Did we lose? I can't tell. Those are all just horse bodies or horse archers? Wow, it actually seems like we lost. These horses are powerful. Let's keep our soldiers somewhat to the back here. Because if we lose all of our soldiers, well, we lose the game. So I'm gonna let them fight it out here. We still got these archers on the walls. Okay, we're gonna lose a couple... We're gonna lose a couple farmhouses here. But oh, we're gonna be attacked again in 6 months? Huh. Maybe this isn't such a good idea after all. We definitely need more military to deal with all of this. Because another nomad camp attack in 6 months? I can't handle that. I'm gonna have to figure something out. Alright, so this is what I did. In 2 months, a Xiongnu army from the nomad camps is going to attack. Let me pause the game here. This attack is still ongoing. it's because they can't actually break through the walls. So, they've just been hanging out here, and my city, although suffered some food supply shortage, so we are a bit short on workers, it's not currently the farming season, so I can decrease the priority on agriculture, so everything else is still doing a-okay. Well, do these count as agriculture? They do, so the fish supply is a little affected, but right now, actually, considering the fish supply is affected, let's put this back to moderate. Okay. So, our farms here were a little affected, but we're gonna be invaded in another 2 months. And I don't know from what direction, but these guys are sort of stuck here. So I'm gonna send these guys back, and I'm gonna wait for the next invasion. And I do have another fort of infantry back set up. And after this invasion, I should be good to go, because I'm putting down a few more forts of soldiers. And I'll be much more protected then. Okay, so here's the other invasion coming from the east side. We could actually bribe 10,200 cash to tell him to go away. But let's try fight to defend the city. And let's slow the game down. And seems like they're coming from here. So let's bring our troops down. We've got 4 full battalions of infantry. We've got a couple charioteers. Come on, why can't I? Okay, a couple charioteers and a handful of crossbowmen. All right, where are they coming down to? This one is a much smaller invasion, unless that's two horse battalions on top of each other. If not, let's go face them. Well, they're actually crossing the pond. All right, let's bring everyone down here. Chariot, come down here. All right, here we go. Meanwhile, this other side, they're still shooting the wall. It's fine. They should be dead by the time the year's out. I thought this invasion was gonna be as big as the other one. Considering it isn't, I'm gonna send 1 battalion of infantry over to that side to start wiping them out. Now let's wipe out these guys, make sure they don't mess with our farmers. We really do need the food this time around. The crossbowmen seem to be doing quite nicely. Don't just stand over there, get over here. We're not even in range of the wall here. Alright, finish him off. So, you guys, head back home. Head back home. Just get these guys all sent back home. Why can't I select this? There you go. Get back home. And we're gonna grab one of you. Send you over here. And let's take care of this invasion. Alright, we've got this one infantry group we sent over here. Time to end this. There we go. Finally, invasion defeated. That was quite stressful. But now that we've gotten past that invasion, let's pause the game. Let's get our farm back up here. We sort of missed the wheat season on this farm. Let's bring this back down and let's replace our fields. Okay, so there you have it. Invasion dealt with. I think, I'm just gonna replace the fields and then now with all of this military, I think we should be good to go. And we even have space to put down some more. I might wanna put down another crossbowman fort if I can find a nice place for it. Let's place it there. We're gonna get a massive military, and basically, on our goals, we have 50 people in humble compound, so all we'd need is to finish this temple complex, because I went ahead and built all of these fancy houses over here, so we should be pretty much set from here on out. Okay, so for the first time, I think we are 100% secure. I went ahead and put down 2 more farmhouses here for wheat and soybeans, and our food supply seems to be pretty much stabilizing. The salt, I also doubled the import of salt by importing from Wu as well as Yulin, and the wood supply was a little erratic, mainly because I went ahead and put down, look at this, all 11 forts. We have a lot. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 infantry forts, 2 crossbows, and 2 chariots over here. So the crossbows and chariots took up some wood as well. I think the crossbows might actually be really powerful units because it takes double the amount of resources. Anyway, I've got these 2 forts down here. They're still being staffed up with weapons. This is going well, this is going well. If you didn't notice before, I actually got... Well, I severely increased the amount of weapon smiths I have because the bronzeware, I'm no longer selling it, and because it distributes so far away, well, it doesn't take up as much bronze. And there's another infantry fort over there. I think we're pretty much impervious to any attack now because we got maximum forces. And food supplies looking as stable as ever. So hopefully we can start feeding all these people in a much more stable way. I have 9 of these humble compounds. So looking at the temple complex, now that the wood supply is going to be coming in much better, it just needs more carpenters and stuff. So how's our employment is doing okay. So let's go ahead and put down more guilds, I think. Another carpenter's guild right there. We might need masons, which means we might need to set up a stone industry, which we haven't yet. I'm not sure if we need to. It'll be pretty easy to do so. I just send this road up here. And I guess I'll just in case, I'm gonna go ahead and put down... How do I do this? Let's put down the inspector's tower first. I'm gonna put down... 2 stoneworks, I guess? And then I'm gonna put down a warehouse. Not too far away. Where can I place this? Can I just place one right here? I guess so. So what do stonemasons get? Is it stone? Bean curd, fish, millet, rice, wheat, salt, wood, bronze, raw silk, jade, clay, hemp, weapons, bronzeware, silk, ceramics, carved jade? What do they dig up out of the ground? It's the new year. Let's celebrate. I won't accept anything here for now. Food supply is still doing okay? Looks good to me. Fish is a little low, but it'll be a bit tricky to... I mean, I could put more fishing keys up this way, but for the inspector's tower, it's a bit weird. It should be doing okay anyway. Tasty food's doing okay? Yeah, it's fine. Alright. So what do they dig up out of the ground? I don't know. Send out stonecutters to quarry huge slabs of stone fashioned into usable blocks. Okay. Well, I guess we'll see how that turns out, but really, all that's left is building this, and it seems like the sand is piling up quite nicely as well. So, the monument's coming along quite nicely now, and it seems to be going through some sort of special phase right now. I'm not sure what's gonna start appearing there, but I did actually find the stone button in this one. Accepting stone. What is...
These buildings are as solid as Mount Taishan.
What is this? Stoneworks Deliveryman, 800 stone. What's going on here? I have no idea what's going on here. I mean, I've started filling this warehouse with stone. It seems to be doing okay. Oh well, I'll come back to that. I want to see what this guy is actually building. Let's speed it up. Ah, there we go. The temple is actually being built now. And it just needs more wood. You can see wood is stockpiling. I'm now selling weapons and wood back into these two places. And selling quite nicely. We should actually drop how much weapon stuff we're stocking in here. Just so it evens out a bit more to the other one. Alright, so everything seems to be going along quite nicely. And we captured an enemy spy, paid ransom of 800 cash. Not really that it's an issue now. We've got 30,000 cash. Our city is pretty much as stable as it can be. Do I want to hold a festival? Yes, hold a festival. Special New Year's bonus. Oh, okay. Reduce building costs, improve production yield, defensive bonus. Special gifts? What's special gifts? I don't really need any of these. So special gifts, I guess. Added a wonderful wild pig to your palace menagerie. Okay. We have a wild pig. Awesome. I mean, there are pandas to capture here. I still don't really know. I mean, you can send them as gifts to people, but I'm not too concerned with capturing the wild animals. So I'm just going along, speeding things up, and watching this palace get built, because I'm not sure how much more it's gonna take. I don't even know if we need stone right now. I mean, we've actually quarried out quite a bit of stone there. You can see that? Are they still making stone? It's producing stone as efficiently as it can. Oh yeah, there we go. We are still making stone. No idea if we need it, but we got a warehouse full of it. And... oh no. The river floods again! So I guess I'll be rebuilding that... all that stuff soon. But besides that... I did squeeze in one more... special building here. It seems like... its desirability is... limiting its evolution. I mean, Oh, there we go. Because I wanted 10 of these, not just 9. But I'm not sure if I'll be able to evolve that one, because I moved the administrative city out of the city. And wow, look at our trade centers. They're just chock full. Anyway, this temple's almost done as far as I know. One slab of clay and a ceramist? That shouldn't take too long. Hey, would you look at that? The roof is now complete. And now it just needs more carpenter stuff. Roof's looking pretty nice. I'm not sure what all this empty space around the temple is for. Is it gonna be like gardens and stuff? Look at that, the temple's pretty done. Yes, have another festival. Ah, there we go, 14 blocks of stone and 56 masons. Is the stone coming down? The stone is coming down. Alright. Look at that, all of this is gonna be stone, I see. So, it's a wall, okay. So good thing I did stockpile all of that stone up there. And it seems to be delivering the stone faster than we can mason it. So let's, any more good feng shui around here? Ah yes, we could place one right there. There we go. Speed up the masonry. There we go, now it's going at double speed. It's still taking a while. Alright, we'll wait for this to be done, and then I'm pretty sure there's gonna be some garden stuff, I guess. Hey, the wall completed, and the garden just appeared. This is quite a joyous occasion. The most harmonious temple complex has been completed. You'll be remembered by Nuwa, the creator goddess, for this great accomplishment. It looks fantastic. Look at that. And that means we should be winning, right? Yep, we'll be winning. There we go.
The impressive new capital at Loyi now stands proudly on the banks of the powerful and unpredictable Yellow River. Unfortunately, the rise of our new capital has also given birth to a new sense of fractious independence among the many cities of the kingdom, the leaders of which no longer bow as low as they once did to the king of Zhou.
Alright, well that is the end of this mission in Loyi. Let's have a look at our score here. It did take us quite a while and the military was a little... Well, you gotta really get on building your army as soon as the map starts. Well, that's gonna be the end of this mission. And, hope you enjoyed it. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.